Holoscream, Busch Gardens, Tampa, 2023. 4:30 in the afternoon. This is the line for Stay and Scream. This is the line for guest services if you'd like to buy a ticket. Busch Gardens is running a special that if you are a pass holder, you can buy one ticket today, get one free. The only way to do that is to go to that giant line. The BOGO deal expires tomorrow. I think you could buy a ticket for a future date. But again, we gotta get into this line. All right, so line for tickets ran 45 minutes, but now we've got our tickets. And we've got a front line fear pass. Total cost for the buy one, get one ticket and the two front of the line passes, $226. All right, so while we wait for the event to kick off, we'll go take a look at merch. Apparently the pink scarecrow prefers this shirt. It's the house shirt. Creep it real, yo. We saw these at SeaWorld last night. I was like, man, that's awesome. I thought it was a sweat towel, because that's what you need when you live in Florida, but it's like a flag. Who's hanging that flag in their house? Got this hoodie, it's really cool looking. They have these jerseys that I love, but do I want to carry it around all night? But we literally got $10 in Busch bucks to spend also, plus our pass holder discount. I mean, it's true. Bucket hats also? Those are cool. Whoa, look at this. Scarlet is back. Scarlet cereal. It's actually a t-shirt in the box, but I love the gimmick. That is cool. They have a lot of furry bones, and the artist is gonna be here Friday, September 29th. The sheet list. So this shirt is funny because this year is the first year that they're not running fiends at Holoscream here. The shirt is awesome. I love the show. I'm kind of pissed that it's gone. Saw this shirt last night too, it's really cool. Future ghost. A spirit sweater, like a paint can threw up on it. You could wear that with the pants.
Yeah.
All right, we're gonna go in the rotting pig speakeasy. This is pretty cool.
There's some people wearing this.
There, piggy, 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 piggy. Oh my. There's all kinds of stuff happening in here. Guy lost his face. Oh, there's a big pig up there too. Like these lightweight bottles, $20. Plastic. We're gonna make our way to the back of the park to eat something and start our night back there instead of watching the opening like we normally do. But as we are going to the back, you can see they've put this big fence around the alligators. It was not here until just a couple months ago. They previously just had this fence, but what ended up happening? Idiots were jumping in and antagonizing the alligators. Well, that was a long walk for no reward. 5:30, they're already shut up for the day. They do open back up again at 7 o'clock when Holoscream starts. Well, as we struck out with food, we are going to do much like Metallica and head back to the front. You will do what I say. What I say. In the store, they have coins. Death Word of Buyer no longer exists from 2017. Unearthed, the Scarlet House, also 2017. And Undead Arena Live, that hasn't been here for a couple years now, 2017. So 15 minutes until open, and the front of the park, courtyard area, is like packed. 6:59, the music has stopped in the plaza. 7 o'clock. Where's the monsters? 7:01. No monsters in sight. They're non-punctual monsters.
A few moments later.
No scare money's up front. So we have to go find the scares. No opening ceremonies. Odd. All right, well, we're gonna head to the newest house first, That is D.H. Bagham's Circus of Fear. So if you're wondering why we pop for express, they pulse people into the houses, and this is the line at open. The lines at Hollow Scream, always off the charts. This is the former location of Deathwater Bayou. I think might have been like the longest standing house in Tampa Busch Gardens history. Check out that facade. Very cool. Tell you, I'm more than impressed.
Oh,
that is amazing. I think that might be one of my favorite houses that they've ever done here.
Oh my god.
I'm glad they do allow video in the house without external lighting, so we're not breaking any rules at this Busch Gardens or at this Hollow Scream at least. To SeaWorld's a different story unless you're meeting a head film. But this is one of those videos that I'll be watching back over and over again. Incredible. So the park opened 17 minutes ago. This is the entrance for Stranglewood Estates already.
It's
the exterior. This house was really good the first time we went through, and I had understood that some of the pieces inside never came to fruition, so I'm really interested in going through this again to see if they've made updates.
Yeah.
My goodness.
Holy cow, that was amazing also. Oh,
so I don't know what dark. Came out in video. Some of it is super dark, but yeah. Wow. I do remember in prior times that we've gone through that we've crawled through and they didn't even have an option to walk through in the past. And I was thinking, I hope they don't make you do that again. And thankfully, they have a bypass thing there. So as annual pass holders, one of our perks for the month is a free drink at HOS, Hollow Scream, at the Giraffe Bar. So we're going to go up and in and see what we can get. And this is the gigantic line for the free drink. Those are the drinks that they have. But this is the line. All right, so we're walking back out of the area where Cheetah Hunt is and Stranglewood. There is a lot of dead space, pardon the pun, in between areas here. There used to be a scare zone a little bit further up the road here, but they've removed it. So once upon a time, it used to be really kind of harrowing trying to get around anywhere without getting scared. Now it seems like there's a lot of open space. We're heading into Vegas. Oh my God. Oh no. I think it's the ice machine from Motel Hell. Oh no. Dear God. Somebody, I'd say call the ambulance, but I mean, look at this guy lost his hand. Oh my God. I'm gonna keep my eye on you. Let's get married. Where's Elvis? Oh no. Got a little thing happening. It's just a flesh wound. You'll be fine. Whoa. Oh dear. So beyond the Las Vegas scare zone, this area used to be a scare zone as well. Either like dolls and toys or church here and nothing now. This big Burning Man used to be the centerpiece of a scare zone. I'm pretty sure last year in this area they had like Grim Reaper-y type people and stuff too. And nothing over here either. There's like a random horde that just came out over here, unless it's cash change for Las Vegas. So we've head towards the back of the park where Christmas House is at Pantopia, and this is where clowns usually used to be, like another horde. Nothing now, I'm assuming because of the construction that's going on behind this wall, but nothing on the other end either. So we're gonna go into the residence home for the holidays. This house was a favorite a couple of years ago. It was a really extreme kind of devil worshiping house, and they toned it down a little bit. Then last year, it was turned into like Santa Claus at Christmas. And then this became maybe one of my favorite houses of all time. They mixed like super satanic and Christmas. It's lovely weather. 90 degrees out right now. Get out of here! We're going in with all the copyrighted music. Delicious! Oh my God. Oh. There's children in cages. Creepy. I think Santa was drunk and angry.
Oh, yeah.
He wasn't a happy Santa this year.
No.
I tried to spread some Christmas cheer and love to him. He wasn't having it, though.
No.
All right, finally, time to eat something. If you're wondering about prices here, you can get 2 French bread pizzas and 2 drinks for $35, or 2 cheeseburgers and fries and drinks for $35. So they do have a stage show that goes on in here, too? Drinks. Pizza, chicken, burgers, Asian wok, not open. My God, it's the genuine Rolling Bones. God, it's the national anthem for Tampa Bay.
Welcome to Big Ass Demolition Derby. We got chaos. We got mayhem.
Woo-hoo! Oh my. Big Ed's. You banga banga. They've got monsters on the bumper cars, but it looks like it's literally Gandalf. I don't know if that's somebody dressed that came here or a monster.
Almost Gandalf.
So now we're in the far back of the park, Chick-fil-A, and nothing back here either. Chasing those kids. They are running. Bang, bang! Oh, the Blood Bar has quite a line. Cirque Extreme has taken over Stanleyville Theater. They were here last year too, but just not when we were here. It started later in the season. They start their next show at 9:30. Timing doesn't work for us here now. We're gonna head back for the Forgotten. It's like a sexy vampire house. This has consistently been my least favorite house here for the last few years. Yo, look at the regular line for this thing. It goes on forever. Oh my God. Even Express is backed all the way up here. We're heading in. Eventually. Yeah. Oh. Stake the vamps. Thank you.
Watch out!
Oh my god. That house has a lot of plastic sheets.
Yeah. Run, run, run.
First they say kill, then they say run. Gotta make up your mind. The weirdest thing happened in that house. There was a worker that came through with a red shirt, and he stopped and he goes, "Hey, it's view from the cheap seats." Right in the middle of the house. Scarecrow is heading into Raven's Mill. Oh my god, Pumpkinhead guy. That was amazing. Well, let's go into Raven's Mill. So I will say, big difference between SeaWorld Hall of Scream and Busch Gardens Hall of Scream is all of the pathway markers and ambiance. Lighting here is good to be able to see things. At SeaWorld, it's like literally just pitch black, and they have props. Oh my god. Guy had like pumpkin seeds and stuff on his face. Oh my goodness. Wow. I love it. Oh boy.
This guy just walked out of there.
Oh my god, the chainsaw's going after that baby.
You gotta walk by real slow. I'm not here.
You'll
see me.
This man is the MVP. He's like, yo, you got a baby? That baby's going home scared. Oh, I have that same mask.
Yeah.
We're going beyond the veil. Man, this bush lives on over here. What's happening here? Oh my. Mushrooms. Oh, it's actually a mushroom. It's amazing. Another man's bush. Oh my. I feel like we're going to a rave. Oh. Skeletor's here.
What?
Oh my. Ram man. Coming up to the Witch of the Woods. And this is the regular line. It is gigantic. We're just walking right in. Express. To the Witch of the Woods, the Witch of the Woods. Can I go see the Witch of the Woods? Uh-oh. Man, this bush. The Witch of the Woods. Some men down. The Witch of the Wood drinks truly. Thank you.
Go, get out of here!
The Witch of the Woods watches the channel because a couple of actors reference us in the house. On the other hand, I feel like there was only a couple of actors in that house. It's the rave yard. Oh my goodness. They got the Home Depot skeleton. New this year, Scaryoke. Photo ops. Sliders. And we're not talking about White Castle. So Bushcraft and Tampa started doing this thing a few years ago called the Junkyard, which is like all just props and pieces left over from haunted houses gone by. Like we've got a desk here from Motel Hell, one of my favorite houses of all time. And going here, they have a Scare Actors also. It doesn't count as a haunted house.
junkyard. Pieces
of everybody. Oh. This is from the butcher zone. I love it. Oh no. There's so much to see. Deathwater Bayou in the junkyard now. Ah! Oh my. Deadfall. World's biggest campfire. More Deathwater Bayou. Wow. The old clown house.
Bye bye.
Back to Vegas. You can see how it looks lit up at night. Elvis is here. It's the king. Oh no. Trying to deliver the luggage. Oh. Elvis has left the building. And the scare zone. Well, Busch Gardens Hollow Scream. I think we've seen about just about everything and done about just about everything, so we're gonna get out of here. We just skipped out on the two shows, but I'll trade that off for going home early. I hate to keep harping on that same thing, but there was a time that that Welcome Plaza was loaded with monsters, and then when you left for the night, there were monsters out here too. The word for the day is sparse. Well, the three of us, including the skeleton in the back, are finally back home from Tampa. It is an epic journey, I feel, every time to get over to Busch Gardens, but
yeah,
it was fun. It was sparse.
Mm-hmm.
What they did have was really good,
yeah,
but they just didn't have a lot of it. You know, and in prior years, we used to just think like there were just scares everywhere
throughout. It was, you know, quiet in a lot of spots.
Lots of roaming hordes, and
mm-hmm.
You know, I think we've been down to like five houses for a while and stuff there too. But what was your favorite house?
I like the Carnival.
Yeah, I like that Circus House a lot, and Stranglewood was really good too.
Oh yeah.
I think, you know, one thing, because we posted a video from SeaWorld Hollow Scream yesterday, and folks, you know, seem like have like a debate in the comments about lack of costumes and things too. That's not the way that SeaWorld and these regional haunts normally kind of roll.
I mean, a lot of independent haunts, they don't have, like, full-blown costumes a lot of times, too. Some people do, and a majority of people just kind of, like, makeup. And some of the makeup is really good. Some of the makeup's not so good at the places. But, you know, I also think that that comes with funding at the parks, and I'm not making excuses for them. Reality, it is a small park, SeaWorld, not doing the greatest, knocking the ball out of the park, or these bush parks. You know, I almost think, like, if they pooled their resources and maybe got rid of Hollow Scream and SeaWorld and put that money towards Busch Gardens again, the event could be, like, knock your socks off type of thing.
Mm-hmm.
But there's so much competition for haunt dollars these days, and Halloween just continues to explode.
Oh, yeah.
That, you know, it's up to people to vote with their pocketbooks, you know, whether they want to pay for an event that might be a fraction maybe of what Horror Nights is. But, you know, on the other hand, Horror Nights, absolute disaster with crowds, especially this year. I mean, it is just wall-to-wall packed people.
Oh my God, yeah.
But in any event, we had a lot of fun, and we're home, and that does it for Hollow Scream, at least for the year. One more theme park haunt checked off the board. But thanks a lot for coming along. Thank you very much for all of your likes, comments, and subscriptions. Treat others the way you want to be treated. Have a great night. See you guys.